Our first speech tonight will be by our keynote speaker, Senator Sal DiDomenico. Senator Sal DiDomenico has served as state senator for the Middlesex and Suffolk District since May 2010. His district includes the communities of Everett, Chelsea, Charlestown, and parts of Boston, Brighton, Cambridge, and the West End of Boston.
He currently serves as the Assistant Vice Chairman of the Senate Committee on Ways and Means, as a Chairman of the Joint Committee on Municipalities and Regional Government. He is also a member of the Joint Committee on Economic Development and Emerging Technologies, the Joint Committee on Education, and the Senate Committee on Bills in the Third Reading.
Prior to his election to the Senate, Senator DiDomenico served four terms on the Everett Common Council and was Chief of Staff to former State Senator Anthony Galluccio. Before entering state government, he worked for 12 years in the hospitality industry at Sinister International Hotels and Marriott International. He's a graduate of Cambridge Ridge and Latin High School in Boston College.
Senator DiDomenico has been a member of numerous cultural and civic organizations throughout the district. He is also a member of the legislature's Cultural Caucus, Elder Caucus, Library Caucus, Nonprofit Caucus, and Public Transportation Caucus.
He was recently named Legislator of the Year by several organizations, including the American Planning Association, the Middlesex Boys and Girls Club, the Joint Committee on Children's Healthcare, and the Middlesex County Bar Association. He has also been recognized for his achievements by Youth Build, Mass Vote, Community Family, and the Massachusetts Association of Community Development Corporation.
He and his wife, Tricia, a special education teacher, reside in Everett with their two sons, Matthew and Sal. Please welcome to the stage our honored guest and keynote speaker, Senator Sal DiDomenico.
Success that's second to none. second place is not good enough for you, which is a great thing to strive for. But I want to come here tonight and tell you that, I shouldn't be saying this, but I'll say it because it's reality. Things are not going to be as perfect as you want them to be. Things are not going to go as smooth as you want them. But the true character of any person is when you see an obstacle, what do you do? Do you hold back or do you go around it? And I know this class will not go around it, they'll jump over it. Because that's what you've always done in your career as students. And, you know, when I said earlier, the greatest title I have is Father. And I know we all strive to be the best of the best. We all strive to have the fanciest titles in today's world. We all strive to be the CEO, the president, the senator. Don't strive to be that just yet. I want more time in my seat. But we all strive for these big titles in life. But the real titles that matter are good son, good daughter, good husband, good father, and most of all, good person. Because at the end of the day, when people talk about you, they're not going to say this was a good president, this was a good CEO. They're going to say, that was a good person. That was a good person. And that's how we should all remember. You know, I have two young children of my own. And one wants to be the president of the United States. He tells me he's going to go to the Oval Office, he's going to have the state senate, Congress, and president. He's got it all figured out. And then he says, but I want to be the best son to you, Dad. I knew that would get a good reaction, see? But it's actually true. He's 7 years old and he said that. And my 8-year-old says, no, I want to be president. So I have two different sons. But it really is the true test of a person. At the end of the day, if you look yourself in the mirror and say, I did my best for others, I took care of my family, I gave back to my community, and now I'm here as a good person. And as we said earlier, you should be coming back to your community and giving back because they've given you so much. They've given you a great education. They've given you great friends that will last a lifetime. They have given you a sense of pride knowing that you received the best education you could possibly get in your academic career. So I know you're going to be successes out there. I know that there's no doubt in my mind that you're going to go out there and you're going to take the world by storm. But there's one thing that I want you to never forget. When you go wherever you're going from this point forward, don't just say that I went to school in the city of Everett. Say, I went to the Pine Ridge Honor School of Science. Be proud of where you graduated from. And you know and I know people are watching all of you. They're watching this school closely because you are doing things right. And the teachers can teach, the administrators can administrate, but the kids are the ones that make it happen. And you have made Pine Ridge Honor School the best. You really have it. You should be very proud of yourselves because without you, there is no school, there is no program, there is no kids coming behind you wanting to be like you. There are no parents coming into your school looking at you saying, I want my kids to be you. You are the ambassadors for the school. Not just this graduation, but going forward. Wherever you are still connected to this school. If you like it or not. But you like it, I'm sure. So my message to you is, don't go out there and rush into everything. We all want to go out there and just get it all at once. Take your time. Be methodical in your approach. And when you hit that barrier, jump over. Hit the second barrier, jump over that one. And come back home someday as great adults doing great things. And the good thing for me is when I speak at graduations, which isn't too often, usually I don't know a lot of kids and I don't know a lot of families. But this school I do. I see you coming out of your classrooms, I see you on the sidewalk, and I see all the pointing at me. I know that guy. Which is great to hear. It is great to hear because I know that you know me, I know you, and you have the support of your state senator. And most importantly, I've become friends to a lot of you. And especially your families. We have a lot of family members here that I know, parents, grandparents, who I've known for many years. And they, no surprise, they're great people doing great things for all of you. So it's my pleasure to be here tonight. I'm not going to keep going on because you're getting diplomas tonight, and that's more important than hearing me speak all night for you. And unfortunately, I have four other events to go to, and I have to speak at them also. But I made a point tonight, and there was at one point in my schedule, my staff's going to have to cancel this speech because I have to be in different places right now. I should be making a speech right now in 5 minutes in Charlestown, but that's not going to happen. I'm going to be a little late there. And I said, you know what, I can't cancel on this group. And I called the school and I said, is there any way we can move things around a little bit just to make sure I'm there and I can talk to you folks? Because it was too important for me not to miss this ceremony tonight. Because you have made me a better state senator and you have allowed me to go to the state house and tell my colleagues what great students we have in our schools and that our money is being spent wisely. You make my job easier. You give me the ammunition I need to go to the State House and tell the Senate President and the Governor to keep funding our schools, to keep providing resources to our schools, because you deserve it, and you're great products for the golf entity. So I want to thank you very much for your support, and thank you for all that you've done to make Pioneer Charter School a great school. Congratulations, and best wishes for a bright future. Thank you very much.